We're in Memphis, Tennessee, birthplace of the blues. Let's head down to the coin toss now. And it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Cincinnati tees up the ball as we get ready for the opening kickoff. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 30-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Big opening. Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
Anytime a running back gets one-on-one with a safety, I think that running back has the confidence in his own athletic ability to be able to make that safety miss and get upfield for some yards. That time, the safety just dominated him, made a great tackle in the backfield for a short loss. Getting him the ball in the passing game creates real havoc for the defense. There aren't many linebackers who can stay with him in coverage, that's for sure.
Gets it, he's in space. Brought down around the 48-yard line. Here's a running play. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. And he's tackled at the 35-yard line.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they looked sharp before this one even started.
Taken down around the 24-yard line.
Red 2, kill. Green 15, 2.
There's a strike complete, and they make the stop around the 20-yard line. This is the ninth play of this drive. Pressure with the pass, incomplete.
Well, the defense takes a chance here by bringing the pressure and the blitz to get after the quarterback. This time, they're able to get through and put the kind of pressure that they'd hoped for on him to force that bad throw.
Red two,
start. Gets rid of it quickly. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. Converts the extra point. A 10-play, 69-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
The score now, 7-0. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 23. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Nice gain as he works the right side. He decides to keep it and picks up 7 yards. He's tackled at the 33-yard line.
Third,
from their own 33-yard line. It's first down.
Set. 180.
Counter to the left. They go to the left for a nice gain. He is drilled at the 34-yard line. There was just no daylight on that play, and the defensive lineman was the reason.
Well, that's one way to get involved in the game. Great stop in the backfield.
From their own 34-yard line, third down. And he hits him hard at the 26-yard line. Smith to punt. Tackle at the 42. 6 points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake.
They'll get the first down.
He made the correct decision to tuck it and go.
Memphis is up by a touchdown. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. With the tailback heading for the corner, and he's level at the 3.
This back might need a breather after that run, but when he comes back, just give it to him again.
They go to the back, and he's hit immediately in the backfield. We've got second and goal. Ball on the 7.
Four down.
Mike 41. You got a wedge there, huh?
Red 2. Orange 3. Orange 3. Easy.
Touchdown, Tigers.
Push by the line and a really nice run. That'll get you into the end zone almost every time.
And he tacks on the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. Tucker fields it at the 1. Oh, man, he took him down hard. The offense takes the field again. They were forced to punt their last time out.
They've been beaten soundly on both sides of the ball, and we haven't even gotten to the second quarter.
Tackle right around the 26-yard line. He's on the run, and down he goes at the 26. Short pass, middle of the field, and he's taken down at about the 31. Makes the catch, but just not enough for the first.
Yeah, they're going to come up a little bit short here. Nice job by the defense of preventing this completion from turning into a first down.
Williams is back deep to return the punt. He's to the 40, and he just got drilled. The Tigers are having a ton of fun down there on the sidelines. You can just see that everything's clicking for them. It's looking easy.
Now, remember, it's still early in this football game, and if I'm the defense on the other side of the football, I'm trying to come up with ways, when we're on the sideline, of what we can do to stop this powerful offense.
They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six. And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
That was just smash-mouth, helmet-to-chin football by the defensive line there. They dominated the point of attack.
Man left, man left. Second down and 11. Ball on the 42.
Check back, back five.
They go to the ground game. They'll bring him down at the 42-yard line. Set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. Montgomery, back deep to return. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. The Tigers are looking downright scary on defense so far, Herbie.
They are flying around as a group right now, completely aware of what this offense is trying to do and dismantling them every single time on every single play.
It's not quite a blowout, but unless they do something here, it might turn into one. There's a very impressive open field tackle. Run there. Caught and a big hit. He stopped in his tracks. Makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line.
They're giving away 3 yards and only making life easier for the guys on the other side of the ball.
And that'll bring an end to the first quarter of action. 14-0, Memphis. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. 3-yard gain by the running back.
Man, it's difficult to run on this defense when they put this kid up in the box.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. Gets out to about the 18-yard line.
That's the second time that this defense has given up a first down on third down. You work so hard as a defense to get an offense to third down. When you get them there, you've got to be able to have somebody step up and make a big play, whether it's a defensive tackle slipping through a block, a linebacker shooting a gap, a defender in the secondary that's able to make a play on a football. Somebody's got to make a play, and that's what winning, the difference between winning a football game and losing is how you're.
Picks up the fumble. The five. He's all the way. Touchdown. And he hits the PAT. Bearcats running back sidelined earlier with that injury. Right now, though, it looks like he's warming up, trying to get back in the ballgame. He's to the 20.
Oh, what a hit.
This defense has everything. They kind of have that blue-collar, workman-like approach, but they also have a blend of tremendous speed to go along with that work ethic. And the better they play, they seem to feed off of it, and it continues throughout the whole ballgame.
This offense has got to try to pull it all together now after the fumble cost them 6 points just moments ago.
I know as a quarterback, it's always hard to watch the defense score a touchdown on you, but it was always a reminder to take extra care of the football.
Mike 35.
Hands off left, and they got him behind the line. Loss of one there for the halfback. It's third down and 10. Ball on the 19-yard line. He lets it go. Open man, and it's his wide receiver.
You can chalk that one up to the hundreds of passes the quarterback has thrown to this receiver in practice. These guys know and trust each other, and you could see it in the way he threw that pass.
Throws it out there. Great concentration to haul it in. Touchdown, Cincy!
Great effort by the wide receiver. And not to take anything away from the quarterback, but the wide receiver made this play.
He makes the PAT. A four-play, 81-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Well, I think the thing, Brad, that I'm seeing is the quarterback's taking advantage of some one-on-one opportunities on the outside for some big plays for this offense.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Gibson from the one, and down he goes at the 27. The Tigers came out of the blocks, and they were on fire, but they've really slowed down here.
Yeah, give credit to the defense that they're facing. Early in the game, as you said, it seems like this offense couldn't do anything wrong, but the last few series, this defense has done a much better job of controlling their big playability.
Blue 14!
He fights forward to about the 30. To the 40. He gets out to about the 44-yard line.
Back you kill.
Scrambling around. Tackle made at the 49. Again, he makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Looks like the defense was in man coverage there, fellas, and that's why they stopped that screen.
Yeah, and when the secondary isn't dropping back into zone, it makes it difficult to have success with that kind of screen play.
Williams is the punter. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
I think this defense right now needs somebody to try to lift up their spirits. They seem to really be just out there kind of going through the motions. And I think the last time they were out there when they gave up such a long drive has had...
Here's the pitch, and now the ball is free. And look at the big guy go. To the 10. Touchdown, Memphis.
Defensive touchdowns give teams such a big morale lift. This was a really nice play to grab the loose ball and take it the distance.
And he adds the extra point. Patterson has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. Across the 30. He's taken down at the 34.
It was a rough road on their last drive as the fumble led to a touchdown.
I know as a quarterback, it's always hard to watch the defense score a touchdown on you. But it was always a reminder to take extra care of the football. I love to see this, Brad. These quarterbacks have the toughest job in college football, and that's to cover some of the fastest players on the field, the receivers. And for a corner willing to come up, get off of his block, and make a play to disrupt the run, that's as good as it gets if you're a defensive coordinator.
Brought down at the 28. From their own 28-yard line, third down. And they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the five-wide set. He's scrambling. Throws out and a leaping interception by the corner. Inside the 30. He's taken down at about the 19-yard line.
Boy, just when it looked like they had a chance to get right back into this game, they throw the interception. Now it's still early. Let's see if their defense can bail them out.
From the 19-yard line, first down. And he's tackled around the 19-yard line. And they get nice yardage on that run. The middle for a nice game. Back to him, and he gets nothing this time around. That brings up a second and goal. Ball on the 7-yard line. Tackled after a decent pickup. Touchdown, Tigers.
There are some guys, when they get near the goal line, they just have a knack for getting the ball into the end zone. That's what we saw right there.
And he converts the extra point. So a 6-play, 18-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart up. It can really demoralize the defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
Memphis, the kick. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 36-yard line. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. Quick strike to the receiver. And they make the stop around the 42-yard line. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. He's hit and taken down. Fires quick, tipped.
That was a nice play to close on the ball like that. You can't teach that kind of reaction. It's just natural ability.
From the 47-yard line, second down. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
I like the scheme the defensive coordinator came up with here. They were all over the place on that play and left the quarterback nowhere to throw it.
They go to him on a quick throw. He's tackled
at about the 17-yard line.
And that's the way you're supposed to play pitch and catch.
Absolutely. You know, this wide receiver is a difference maker. He's one of those players that has a chance to go the distance every time you get him the ball.
Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal.
All right, D, let's go, let's go, let's go.
They'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
Well, you can really mess with an offensive game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
From the 8-yard line, it's second down. Looks like he flinched down there on the line.
It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a 5-yard setback can do damage to a drive.
Taken down in the backfield.
That's a great play by the defense. There's nothing like a defense being able to slip off of a block, get into the backfield of the offense, and then make a play in the backfield to be able to create some momentum possibly for this defense.
This is the ninth play of this drive. He lets it go. Caught end zone for the touchdown. Did that play ever develop nicely?
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 30-yard line. The Tigers are just cruising through this first half, Herbie. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, but still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that it's a four-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry.
Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. On the delay, makes it out to about the 40. The Tigers will use their first time out of the half. From their own 40-yard line, it's first down. Tries to scramble, but he's sacked.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. And don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
Back five, back five.
Throws it in a hurry. And down he goes to the 39-yard line.
Did you see how he looked that ball into his hands? That's how you catch a football.
Caught it, but they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately. That's a 2-yard loss.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
And watch out. They're going to bring the heat right here. Quarterback is on his way back onto the field, and he led a great drive last time out. Looking for his man, incomplete. From their own 34-yard line, it's second down. Fires out quickly to the tailback. They'll bring him down around the 48-yard line.
Check, check. Regular, regular, regular.
Check 13.
Here we go. 180. One.
Quick throw. Almost intercepted. From their own 48-yard line. Second down. Let's see if a quarterback heaves it up there and one of his guys can come down with it. Going deep. Can't haul it in. First half comes to a close as they head to the locker rooms. The Tigers with a 3-touchdown advantage.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half.
These offenses seemingly took advantage of every opportunity to make a big play. They were prolific, explosive plays at every turn, offensive coordinators dialing up great calls at just the right moment, it seems.
No, it did seem that way, and everything worked, but there's also the other side of the equation, too, and we talk about it all the time. You want to make top 10 plays, and you want to be celebrated. You want to see your clip for a couple days on SportsCenter, but when you're on defense, you can't always make a big SportsCenter play. You can't try to decapitate somebody every single time. It's okay to make the easy tackle, grab their legs, wrap them up. Right now, a lot of sloppy tackling is making the offensive guys look 10 times better than they should be. You don't have to make SportsCenter. You could just make the regular, normal, everyday play.
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 35. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Tackle at the 36. Taken down at the 50. Quick throw out to the receiver. Tackle made at the 14. Outside for a nice game. Gets to about the 8-yard line. Caught, and he's hit immediately. They get 3 yards on the play.
This young wide receiver has the raw ability to make some big plays. So that was a good job there by the defense to stop him for a short game.
This isn't much more than an extra point. Kicks away, and it is good. Cincinnati ready to kick this one off. Gibson takes it at the 4, makes it to the 22-yard line. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. He fights forward to about the 23. It quickly. Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Brought down at the 43.
Check back 11.
going to try and scramble. He's taken down at the 49-yard line. Going to get it. Great stop. He doesn't want a touchback here. He wants to knock this ball inside the 10. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. And he tackles him hard at the 21-yard line. Second and 13. Ball on the 21. He gets to about the 31-yard line. He caught some key blocks and was able to turn it into a 10-yard gain. Fires out to his wideout. Good tackle there in space. Tackled at the 43-yard line.
Hold up. Let's go. On the ball. Quick.
Loose football. And it's picked up by one of the linemen.
Get on.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 33. He makes it to the 32-yard line. Gains his way to the 23-yard line. Him, and this time they get him in the backfield. Big play, and it's first and goal. Just yet. And he adds the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Gibson from the one at the 30, and he's tackled at the 33-yard line. The Bearcats defense really looked pathetic in that first half, Kirk, and now they're doing a nice job.
Well, obviously, they've made some adjustments after the first half, and it's paid off for them. I think right now they're tuned in to what this offense is trying to do, and I think they're also just playing with a little bit more of a chip on their shoulder.
So we're just about ready to return to action. Sides, got his tailback, and they make the stop at the 37.
Check.
Scrambling around. Very good tackle in space.
Woo!
down behind the line.
Too easy, too easy.
Williams is waiting for the snap. He's taken down at the 29-yard line.
This receiver's been having himself a great game.
You know, Brad, he's just one of those go-to guys. And when he catches fire, there's just not a lot of defense can do to slow him down.
He's blowing big holes through them on a clip of over 20 yards a grab. Well, the numbers always look good on the stat sheet, but they're going to need to put up points.
The offense now will take the field, and they hope to have the same success they had on their last drive.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receiver. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now it's really paying off.
From their own 26-yard line, second down. Goes right, picked off. He came up with a fantastic interception there.
Well, you know the quarterback is kicking himself for that one. He just made the wrong read.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 39-yard line. Looks left, finding his tailback. He's pushed out of bounds at the 18-yard line. For a loss. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
Concentration laps right there. The coaches will be giving them an earful for it, too.
First down. Defense trying to prevent any more damage. First and goal inside the five. Dives for extra yardage. So he gets maybe a yard on the option. Got to be careful of a pass play with this defense. Quick throw, caught, touchdown. And he converts the extra point. So that's a five-play, 25-yard drive, and they get it in for seven.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Memphis to kick this one off. Taken from the three-yard line. Tackle made at the 29. An interception cut this offense last drive short, so I think they're going to be looking for a little more success right here.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially.
That's three down and one to go. The Tigers with an 18-point cushion. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action.
Ready,
ball's loose. It's scooped up, and it's a lineman that's got it. Third and long now after the sack. He's tackled right around the 48-yard line. And we got an injured player on the field. From the 28-yard line, first down. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Short pass, middle of the field. And down he goes, right around the 26-yard line. They'll spread the field with five wide. And they'll look to convert here on another third down.
Here we go! 395!
He's wrapped up for the sack. Launches one for the end zone. He caught it. Touchdown. So the kicker's going to stay on the sidelines. These guys will try for a two-point conversion. Might have been some early movement up front.
Just a mental lapse, but it's going to cost him 5 yards.
And they're looking to get 2 points here. And they won't get the two.
An 8-play, 73-yard drive. But the failed 2-point conversion keeps it a 6-point score.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school. Grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
He'll return it from the three. Inside the 30. He finally goes down at the 11-yard line. There's a flag down, and it looks like this one's coming back. Flipping is the call, and now they'll have to find a way to make up those yards right here.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop.
They'll bring him down at the 24. On the run, and they bring him down for a sack on the play. They come up to the line here. It's second down and 14 after the sack. Complete, brought down, nothing doing.
Hey, check back the ladder, check back the ladder. carries it, but he can't shake the defense. Taylor picks up about 4 yards with the catch. Montgomery back deep to return. Brought down at the 42-yard line. It's been an impressive game by this defensive lineman.
You know, you hear a lot of coaches talk about a ball hawk. Well, this is a classic example of a young man that just has a feel, who always seems to be able to make plays for this defense.
If you want to point to certain individuals as reasons why they're winning, he'd be a good start. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Around the 44-yard line.
Man, did he ever sell the run? The defense took the bait, and that hesitation was enough to give the receiver room to make the catch.
Gets to about the 41-yard line. Gets rid of it. Third down now. They need to get it down to the 34. He lets it fly. Picked off. It's the ball-hawking freshman. He tried to force that one in there.
Yep. And the safety made him pay for it. Great job of watching the quarterback's eyes and even a better catch.
Scrambling. Tackle made around the 16-yard line. Brought down around the 13-yard line.
The way the safety was playing up toward the line of scrimmage shows you what they think of the offense's passing game. Not a lot of respect for it.
From their own 13-yard line. Third down. Setting up blockers, or running backs got it on the screen, and he shoved out of bounds at the 16-yard line. And watch out, they're going to bring the heat right here. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. You know the offense will be looking to do better this time out.
The best way to move beyond a turnover is to score. And when you can start on the other team's half of the field, you're in really good shape to have a chance to do that.
Wants to go long and does. Interception. Job to pick that ball off.
He did a great job at getting in that passing lane and coming away with the ball.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 16. Just over 2 minutes in the game. And he's taken down at the 31. Keep it on the ground again. They go to the left for a nice game.
Taylor picks up five with the carry. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. That's a great tackle at the 32.
Those linebackers do a great job of stopping the run, but they need to be careful of the play-action pass. You can easily get fooled and give up some big yards through the air.
Passes it to the middle of the field. Excellent open field tackle. A yard, maybe two on the screen pass. Cincinnati's out of timeouts. Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. Gets to about the 37-yard line. Well, let's see if he can shake off that pick that he tossed last time out.
And I don't think this defense will lay down lightly. They're going to try to continue to rattle this guy.
Gets it out quickly. He's taken down at the 49-yard line. He flings it left. Open man, and it's his wide receiver. And he's tackled at the 12-yard line. A little over a minute in the game. Gets it to his wide receiver, and he's got another one. In the fourth quarter, one possession game, and this is where poise really takes over. Whoever shows it will win the football game. And he adds the extra point. At the 42. So not a lot of time left, and they've got an opportunity right now, if they score, to put the nail in the coffin in this game. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. So it's second and 12. Ball on the 44-yard line. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. This one's in the books, and our final score, Memphis 42, Cincinnati 37. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.